What's up, everybody? Well, I got another gameplay video for you guys today, and today we're gonna finish up Need for Speed Unbound, and we're gonna do so on my main computer here, which is a 13900KF and then an RTX 3090. It's an MSI Gaming Trio. It only has a triple pin 3-pin on it, but still seems plenty powerful to me. And then we got 32 gigs of 6400 megahertz CL32 DDR5. It's cooled by Custom Loop, which is an EK Vector 2 block, and then it's a 420 millimeter radiator with some industrial Noctua fans on there. They're really just there for if I feel like trying to do some crazy overclocking that they don't spin very fast at all, as you can tell. I have them turned way down at normal temperatures. It's just they spin up like crazy when it gets when the CPU gets kind of hot, which the 13900KF will do if you do like edit a video not using the GPU or do a Cinebench run or something. And then the motherboard is a ASUS Z790 Gaming E, and then it's all powered by a 1600 watt EVGA PSU platinum rated one. Anyway though, why don't we go ahead and hop on into the game and see how it runs. My guess is going to be amazingly.
Let's get started with some gameplay on the main computer. Now we're going to be playing at 4K on this guy. We'll do DLSS at the end, and it looks like this game has that frame generation, so I'll make sure to do that as well. And we're going to start off on low, even though nobody would probably be playing on low on a system like this, but I did that on the rest of the system, so I figured, why the fuck not? So, into the game, and here we go. We're on low here, and wow, we're getting, like, more FPS. Way more FPS than we were getting on ultra-wide, even. That just goes to show you how powerful 4090 is, though. But for all I know, maybe this game prefers Intel more than my 5800X 3D as well. Maybe that's also celibate. But it's getting close to the same CPU use. It just one's a little lower utilization because it's got more cores and whatnot. But the other one was getting up to like 55, 57. And this one's going up to 48. Almost up to 50 right there, so. Now, one thing I wonder. Does it only use performance cores to game with, or will it also use some of the lower-end cores too? It kind of looks like it uses everything from the looks of the CPU, but I just kind of talking out loud there, wondering. But from the looks of it, that's how it works, but just because it looks like that, I guess, doesn't necessarily mean that's how it works. But if I see it right in front of my face, that's how I'm going to claim it works anyway. But obviously, if I'm wrong, someone can correct me. Yeah, this seems to be a pretty CPU-intensive game, honestly. Oh, shit. Wall. Let's not damage her too much. I'm trying not to, but shit. It's hard to not crash in this game sometimes. Anyway, though, let's move along to the next set. Moving on to medium now. I wished we could have HDR on, but if I have HDR on, it makes the game look like 10 times worse than it does even with it off, so I don't record with that. Hopefully one day Shadowplay will let me get HDR recordings, but until then, not doing it. Anyway, we're going to be on medium, as you can see here, and we've already been at the bottom for a minute, so let's get into the game, shall we? All right. Let's get old medium in now. Let's just drive around, see how it does. Kind of funny listening to how quiet it is. And I think my receiver is finally about to die. Or something. Because every once in a while, it'll just like make a bunch of random like crazy pops and crinkles. It sounds like the damn computer becomes possessed by a fucking demon or something. But it fucking scares the shit out of me and scares the shit out of Misty when it happens. So that's the only thing I can think of. I turn the receiver off and on, and it fixes the problem. I feel like if it was on the computer side, I'd have to do a restart. Like, turning the receiver on and off wouldn't do anything. Like, if it was just like a driver fucking up in the background of Windows, I feel like I'd turn the receiver off and on, and it would still be making the same fucking sound as soon as you hear the little receiver click back on, you know? But nope. It stops doing it immediately. So, I don't know what's up with that. But might be time to start looking at a new receiver. But, I mean, this thing is from 2005. It was actually a graduation gift from my mom, getting out of high school. It was like a Senkei, it's almost an $800 fucking setup. Got it from Circuit City when there was such a thing. So, might be about time to get a new one. But that's okay, maybe I can find a nice Dolby Atmos one. Because now I know I don't need no 1000 watts for a receiver anymore. Wattage does not equal badassity. Not that this is a bad receiver by any means, but just high wattage doesn't necessarily mean it's going to be like the best sound quality and all that shit, is I guess where I'm getting at. Well, now we're going to move along to high, so let's cruise through the settings really fast. Here we go. As you can see right there, we're on high. So now, why don't we go ahead and get back on into the game to get a little gameplay in. Well, here we go. Get a little high gameplay in now. We'll just take out that gas pump on the way. And yeah, we're still getting very good FPS. 130. This is only a 120 hertz TV, so hell, right now I'd be, if I locked VSync on, I'd be just set and golden. Nope, there we go. We dropped under 120 there. But with G-Sync and all that shit and no frame rate counter on, I don't think I'd have fucking noticed that, to be honest with you guys. It's easy to sit here and go, oh man, it dropped below, when you sit here and have a frame rate counter the whole time watching it like a hawk more than you're actually enjoying playing the game. But I found if you just turn the frame rate counter off, as long as you're getting the frame rate you desire and just shut that damn thing off and enjoy the game, I mean, you can have fun with even low-ass FPS, like Steam Deck. Like, as long as that's a locked 30, since it's a controller, that's not so bad. Don't get me wrong, I would still much prefer 60. But that's why I'm also glad it has 40 as an option, because sometimes you can get 40, and 40 is still better than 30. But I think it must be the fact that it's a controller. Controllers must just deal with lower FPS easier than having a keyboard and mouse. Keyboard and mouse just feels so sluggish at 30. I just can't do 30 no matter what on a PC. At least if the game is keyboard and mouse. And I can't really do it with driving games, I just suck. Ah, cool, I got another achievement. All right, I guess I drove around for 100 miles already. Yeah, makes sense, I have been fucking all over the place. Not doing any races or anything, just driving around like a lunatic. Anyway, why don't we move on? The time now has come for ultra quality, so let's go look through these settings real quick, and as you can see right here, we're now on the ultra preset. So, why don't we get back to the game and see how that fares? Well now, here we go all with ultra. Let's just drive around a little and see what kind of FPS we get. It seems like it can drop into the 100s, like low 100s, but for the most part, we seem to be up close to 120. Bouncing between 116 and 120. Oh, we dropped down to 100 there, though. Again, though, don't think I'd really notice that with this frame rate counter thing with the G-Sync and all that shit. But just saying. I love how people like teleport out of my way at like Super Saiyan level of speeds. It's pretty awesome. And I think that was pretty bad. Huh, there's like random clothing coming out of the bottom of the car. That's pretty interesting. Sorry, Dodge Caliber, you're all dead. Anyway, let's move on. Now, before moving into DLSS, I figured we'd try out some of that frame generation stuff. So let's get down to it. As you can see, I turned on DLSS frame generation, but I'm not turning on any other DLSS. We're just gonna run in just the frame generation. Then we'll turn it off and do DLSS. Well, all right, guys, let's do some of that frame generation stuff. Get a little game plan. Yeah, I can definitely tell by looking at the frames anyway. It's saying we're getting a bunch more frames, but these are completely fake frames. Now, I'm not going to sit here and lie. I don't really notice a huge latency difference or like any problems running this. Like, I'm sitting here now, I'm not actually playing and just doing voiceovers, and I'm sitting here looking for problems, just looking for things that aren't right. And I'm just not seeing anything. Like, I feel like I'd have to slow down the video to like, and like zoom in on shit maybe. But if I have to do that, I feel like the freaking thing is working just fine. Now, what I think this might suck at is if you try to do a first-person shooter where you're using a mouse and keyboard. I haven't played a first-person shooter with the frame generation yet, so I can't really give my opinion on that. But I think that's where we might get into some trouble. But, hell, this is a pretty awesome way to just get extra frames, whether they're fake or not. If the AI can actually put the fake frames in there and make it actually work, I mean, shit, I'm all for it. But I have a sneaking suspicion that we're going to start getting into situations where if you don't have one of the new cards, people are going to start making the game like shit and relying on this kind of technology to get by. Kind of like some games kind of rely on DLSS just to be playable with like ray tracing and everything. But that doesn't necessarily mean it's a bad coded game or anything. It's just some are just so graphically intensive, they need help from shit like this. I wish that they would rather just make it play better on native, and then these things could be like in an emergency only situation, you know? Anyway, let's move on. All right, well, my receiver scared the shit out of me and did that weird stuff right as I tried to start this shit. But anyway, we're gonna do DLSS quality now. Now that we've done the frame generation. So yeah, I think it's about time for me to get a new receiver. That's really starting to piss me off. But it's old, it's from 2005. Like, I gotta let it go sooner or later. It's bound to break. Anyway, to the game. All right, let's get ourselves some DLSS gameplay in now. We're gonna start off with DLSS quality. And we can definitely tell it makes a difference because maxed out on Ultra, we were dropping down to 107, 113 back there. Now we've got it on, we're going up to 120, 130 here. So it definitely made a difference. Now, I wonder if that just means it's working better in this game than FSR. But again, both my NVIDIA computers are on much higher resolution monitors, so it might just be the resolution coming into play, but it's two different technologies. They do the same thing, but they work slightly differently. So it's kind of hard to compare apples to oranges, you know? But at least I can say it's actually doing something here. Now, I wonder, am I going to get random stutters here too, like I did on my secondary computer since I'm recording and have DLSS on? I'll have to try and pay attention and see. Maybe this computer's just so powerful it won't. So far, so good. It seemed to happen when I was like really fucking ripping ass through the city here, like going 160 and shit. I don't know if I'm gonna be able to get up to that kind of speed though, nah. But I can do a drift. Alright though, I think that's good enough. Why don't we go ahead and move on to the next DLSS setting. Last up, we got ourselves some DLSS performance before we get on to my settings. Oh wait, no, it's balanced. Balance, excuse me, we're doing balance first. I'm getting ahead of myself here. So, we're still on ultra and all that stuff, but it is balanced, not performance. We'll do that one next. But, let's get into the game and see how balance does first. Let's get ourselves some DLSS balance gameplay in now. Do a quick donut first. Alright, yeah, we got some of that stutter now. You know what it might be? A resolution might just drop down too much, and then like maybe the CPU bottlenecks the GPU a little bit, because we're not getting full usage anymore. Before we turned DLSS on, we were. But obviously you guys all know the DLSS is upscaling, so it lowers the resolution, which puts more strain on the CPU. And I just put more stress on that cop's car and then crashed it into some eatery. I would definitely be surprised. You're sitting there eating some pancakes. Next thing you know, you've got a fucking cop car on your table. Double kill. Damn, that's a big ass fountain. Oh shit, that's a wall. Oops. I pretty much nitrous'd right into that fucking wall, didn't I? If we'd been in that car, dead. All right, now it is time for DLSS performance. I know I'm getting it right this time. We just did balance. There's no way it can't be performance. Anyway, we've just reached the bottom. We're still on Ultra and all that good junk, so let's get back into the game, see how it does. Well, all right, guys. Let's get ourselves in some DLSS performance before we get to my settings. Yeah, I don't really know if we're necessarily really getting any more FPS than we were before. I think quality or balance might be the way to go if you guys want to use DLSS in this one. Just like on the other computers, it seems to give us less performance. Or just like equal to, so why have less resolution and all that shit if you're not getting any extra performance out of it, right? That only makes sense, so just go with one of the better looking options. Although, not gonna lie, I can barely tell a difference. I can tell a small difference if I really look for it, but if I'm just sitting here playing, like trying to drive this car, I don't think I'd even notice. Wonder what resolution it's actually running at right now. And upscaling to 4K. And I'm now on the freeway. Oh no, it's not a freeway. Shit! I fucked myself up real good. Do a little donut. Coming through. And then nitrous right into a fucking shot. Haha, that's what you do. Alright though, why don't we move on to my settings now. Alright, now let's do my settings. So let's just cruise through here. I decided to just go fucking ultra graphics. I didn't really think we were dropping frames so far that we really needed anything, you know? I just put everything on ultra besides that. Let's pop that up to ultra too, fuck it. So now our game is truly maxed out, so. Let's go see how it plays. Now we're on my settings, so let's go drive around and see how that does. We still drop under 120 here and there, but. As long as we stick close to that, I think I'd be a happy camper. That sure didn't work out in my favor at all, did it? Oh, there's a ramp. All right, well, let's go over back here and go over the ramp then. Fuck it. That'd be kind of fun. Probably not going to jump do a giant jump. Since I'm not going to be able to go fast enough. Ah, you have to use that shit real soon. Or real quick. Maybe if I would have used that right away, I would have gotten a good jump. But hey, we can still use a jump. No, but we did eventually, didn't we? All right, guys, let's get ourselves some camera gameplay now. Like I thought, this computer play this game native, no problem. I don't even need DLSS. Oh, I hit your van, guys.
All right, back to the city. So far, it seems at least like a pretty interesting game. I'll definitely probably play it. Whoop, almost went head on into a cop. Oops. We can do better than that. Hell yeah. Uh-oh. I got too much air. That did not work very well. Oh well. Take that, Infinity. Well, where should we go now in the city? Why don't we go this way, I guess. Damn straight I am, cause you super nub cake. Super nub cake McGee. That's you. Oh yeah, we have escaped. All right,
And after crashing into that thing, why don't we go ahead and wrap this video on up?
Well, all right, guys, that's a wrap for Need for Speed Unbound. And this computer handled it absolutely flawlessly, but I knew it would. It even had some of that weird frame generation shit, but I don't like screen tearing, so I don't see myself using that one. Unless a game is, like, a couple years down the line, is so overpowering that I have to use it. But then maybe it won't hit 120 and I won't get any screen tearing, so maybe it won't be an issue. But anyway, I hope you guys enjoyed this video. It's very fun making it. Haven't played a Need for Speed game in quite some time. Anyway, I hope you guys enjoyed this. And until the next one, peace out, guys.